وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال. وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
In Islam, a believing woman is not permitted nor is she allowed to marry a disbeliever. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala clearly and categorically prohibited it in the Quran. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam prohibited it. The issue is a unanimous agreement. Yani there is no difference of opinion that a believing woman cannot marry a disbelieving man. It's a matter of consent. It's an ijma', and inshallah ta'ala I will mention the people and the scholars who've transmitted that consent, inshallah ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says in the Quran, وَلَا تَنْكَحُ الْمُشْرِكِينَ حَتَّى يُؤْمِنُوا وَلَعَبْدٌ مُؤْمِنٌ خَيْرٌ مِّن مُشْرِكٍ وَلَوْ أَعْجَبَكُمْ أُولَئِكَ يَدْعُونَ إِلَى النَّارِ وَاللَّهُ يَدْعُو إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ وَالْمَغْفِرَةِ بِإِذْنِ وَيُبَيِّنُ آيَاتِهِ لِلنَّاسِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَذَكَّرُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, do not marry the believing women to the polytheistic men. Do not marry the believing women to the disbelievers. حتى يؤمنوا, until they believe in Allah, until they surrender to Allah, until they submit to Allah's religion. Do not marry your daughters, do not marry your sisters, don't marry your women to these disbelievers. Allah is clearly and categorically saying that. Until when? حتى يؤمنوا, until they believe. Then Allah goes on to say, وَلَعَبْدٌ مُؤْمِنٌ خَيْرٌ مِّن مُشْرِكٍ. A believing man is always better than a disbeliever. وَلَوْ أَعْجَبَكُمْ. However much this disbeliever fascinates you, he may fascinate you in his character, he may attract you in his personality, his charisma, his humor, the way he looks, his appearance, his physique, all of that, Allah is saying, the believer is always better. Allah then goes on to say, أُولَٰئِكَ يَدْعُونَ إِلَى النَّارِ. These people are calling you to the hellfire. The people who are advocating that a believing woman can marry a disbeliever are calling you to the hellfire. They are calling you to destruction. They are calling you to the hellfire. That's what they are calling you to. وَاللَّهُ يَدْعُو إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ وَالْمَغْفِرَةِ بِإِذْنِ. Allah is calling you to paradise. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is also calling you to his forgiveness. Allah wants to expiate your sins for you. Allah wants to take you to paradise. Allah wants to put you in a high position in paradise. And then Allah goes on to say, وَيُبَيِّنُ آيَاتِ. Allah is clarifying his verses to you. لِلنَّاسِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَذَكَّرُونَ. Perhaps they can remember. In another ayah, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he says, فَإِنْ عَلِمْتُمُوهُنَّ مُؤْمِنَاتِ فَلَا تَرْجِعُوهُنَّ إِلَى الْكُفَّارِ لَا هُنَّ حِلُّ لَهُمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحِلُّونَ لَهُنَّ. Allah is talking to the Prophet in this ayah. Allah is saying to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, these women who have come to you, Muhammad, who migrated to Medina, if you've come to realize, you've now gained knowledge that these women are believers, do not return these believing women to their husbands who are disbelievers. Why? Allah says, لَا هُنَّ حِلُّ لَهُمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحِلُّونَ لَهُنَّ. They are not allowed to be with one another. They're not allowed to stay together. They can't be in a relationship together. A believing woman cannot be in a relationship with a disbeliever. So what is the Prophet commanded to do here? He's told and he's commanded to separate them. And they've been married before as disbelievers. Both of them are disbelievers. Now the woman has now become a believer. Allah is telling the Prophet, separate them. What would the situation then be? A woman who's a believer, she's going to a disbelieving man. This is not a marriage. This is fornication. This is zina. This is adultery. It's haram. بِإِجْمَاعِ أَهْلِ الْعِلْمِ. Ibn Qudama transmitted a consent. Ibn Abdul Barr rahimahullah transmitted a consent. Imam al-Shawkani transmitted a consent. Ibn al-Mundhir transmitted a consent. يعني there are no difference of opinion in this issue. The ayat are clear cut. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَلَنْ يَجْعَلَ اللَّهُ. Allah has not made لِلْكَافِرِينَ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ سَبِيلًا. Allah has not made a disbelieving man authority over a believing woman. A disbeliever cannot have authority over a woman. When a man and a woman marry, there has to be someone in charge. الرجال قوامون على النساء. A man is in charge of the relationship. Just like a country, there has to be a person in charge. In a relationship, there's someone who's in charge. Who's in charge? It's the man. So a believing woman will end up being controlled by who? A disbeliever. Not only that, the believing woman will give birth to a child for who? A disbeliever. And the name of who would be carried on here? Whose lineage is she carrying on? Whose offspring will this? It's the disbelieving man. And so she's now spreading, she's increasing the numbers of the disbelievers. Islam does not permit that. ولذلك our messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام, his own daughter this happened to. Zainab رضي الله تعالى عنها, the Prophet's daughter عليه الصلاة والسلام, she was married to Abu al-As ibn al-Rabi'. Abu al-As ibn al-Rabi' was a disbelieving man. He didn't believe in the Prophet, he didn't believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay? Now, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Battle of Badr took place. The Prophet took Abu al-As ibn al-Rabi', the Prophet took him as a captive, and he was from the captives of the Battle of Badr. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, you will be freed with the condition that you return my daughter Zainab to me. You return my daughter Zainab to me, and you will be freed. You're a free man, you can go. But return my daughter back to me. He then said, okay, I will. He then went back, he returned the Prophet's daughter back to him. Why? Because he's a disbeliever and the Prophet's daughter is a believer. And then Alhamdulillah, Abu al-As ibn al-Rabi', he took Islam, he converted to Islam, he reverted to Islam, he embraced Islam, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam returned Zainab back to him. Yani she's your wife now, because you're a believing man and she's a believing woman. So what I say, brothers and sisters, after we've heard what the Quran has to say, we've heard the Quranic discourse, we've heard what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did, we've also seen the consensus that these great scholars I mentioned, Ibn al-Mundhir, Ibn Qudama, Ibn Abdul Barr, Al-Imam al-Shawkani, these scholars I'm mentioning, they are all saying there is no difference of opinion. After that, what path is open for you? What choice do you have? Allah says, وَمَا كَانَ لِمُؤْمِنٍ وَلَا مُؤْمِنَةٍ إِذَا قَضَى اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ أَمْرًا أَنْ يَكُونَ لَهُمُ الْخِيَرَةُ مِنْ أَمْرِهِمْ. After Allah and His Messenger have passed a law in a matter, Allah and His Messenger have given a final verdict in a matter, you and I have no choice. All that is open for us is submission. We have to accept what Allah and His Messenger said. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said about the believing men that when they are called, the believers, the people who've tasted Iman, when they are called to Allah's law, when they are called to Allah's judgment, when they are told Allah has passed a law in this issue, Allah has passed a verdict in this issue, what do they do? إِذَا دُعُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ لِيَحْكُمُ بَيْنَهُمْ أَنْ يَقُولُوا سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا. They say, we hear, O Allah, and we obey. They don't question Allah's verdicts. They don't question Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's judgments and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They don't put their desires over the statement of Allah and His Messenger. There's no other path that will bring us success and prosperity and good and harmony and tranquility and joy except the law of Allah Azza wa Jalla and the law of His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah created us. He knows us better than ourselves. He knows what's good for us. He knows what our body needs. He knows what our minds need. He knows what will bring about happiness, will remove from us grief, will remove from us sorrow. Only Allah knows subhanahu wa ta'ala. How are we going to question Allah Azza wa Jalla in His judgment when He's the same Lord who created you, your gender, He's the one who created your essence, He brought you into this world, He governs you, He controls you, He runs your affairs. The same way He didn't consult you in creating you, He doesn't have to consult you in His judgments and the law He passed and the verdict that He gives. Brothers and sisters, submit and take what your Lord has to say, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.